Hey everyone, and welcome to SkillCapped. I'm King, and today we're doing something fun. We've done a lot of in-depth videos on things that you can do that'll improve your Valorant gameplay, but I thought it would be fun to make a video just covering a bunch of different tips that you can utilize in Valorant. These are going to be ranging from things like settings to aiming mechanics, and frankly, you may know a few of these tips I mentioned. But my goal is to come up with 50 Valorant tips that you can use in less than 10 minutes, because sometimes you just hear those little bits of information you've never heard before that can be really helpful for improving your game. And this way, you don't need to piece through 100 different videos to find one thing that you don't know. I'm going to list all of the most useful things here in this video. So stick with us as we get into it, but before we do, let's introduce our question of the day, which is, what is the most helpful Valorant tip you have for new players? Maybe you're a brand new player yourself and there's something that you learned that helped you, or maybe you're a veteran player looking to pick up a thing or two. Either way, let us know in the comments down below, and on that note, our editor can start the clock now. Your mouse sensitivity is mostly preference, however the general rule of thumb is you should be able to do a 180 with a swipe of your mouse from the center of your mouse pad. This is because generally if you have good crosshair placement, most of your enemies should be in front of you, so you won't need to turn around all that often. Having a large minimap is a great way to increase your awareness. Here are the settings I use to have my map large while still being able to see it all. Most players play on low settings for maximum FPS, with all extra features disabled. The one feature I do recommend having turned on is Bloom. This will make it so it's easier to see things such as Sova recons and character outlines. Gonna be honest, I don't know if it actually affects anything else, probably gun skins and stuff too, but yeah, it might give you an advantage. I saw this one on Shroud stream recently. The hold and the toggle for aim for sniper rifles seems to function pretty differently. This is especially noticeable with the operator, and if you're using hold instead of toggle, it actually allows you to scope in and out much more freely. If you hold Alt, you can actually see the abilities your teammates have available. This will let you know if your Sage used her heal on herself at 98 HP while you actually had 1 HP. This is set to Alt by default, but if it's not Alt for you, you can find it here in the settings. If you want to practice spray control, spend a few minutes in the range just spraying at the wall. Try to get your first 6-7 bullets to land in the same spot, since this is fairly consistent. As you get more comfortable, start adding more bullets. If you want to practice spray transferring, you could do this on the flying bots outside of the range. Practice transferring between the flying targets, and your muscle memory will carry over into the game. You can practice your sensitivity and general mouse control by just aiming at a bot's head in the practice range and running around. Or, you know, you could download Aim Labs, but this is a good way to do it in-game, and I know some pros have mentioned this. Similarly, if you want to practice your peeking, you can use a Sage wall or do it behind this post. One of the biggest advantages of warming up in Valorant instead of Aim Labs is you get to practice your movement as well, so these exercises can be great. Many players have fallen prey to the ziplines in Valorant once or twice, but they're actually pretty simple. Whichever direction you want to exit is the direction you should be pressing to go up. So if you exit to the left, press A. If you exit to the back, press S. Now you'll never get stuck on a zipline again. Breach's flash takes 500 milliseconds to detonate. The average human reaction time is 250 milliseconds. I believe this 250 milliseconds comes from tests like Human Benchmark, where you're anticipating the stimulus though. Notice how when I'm expecting my screen to turn green, my reaction time is around 194 milliseconds. However, according to research, when you're not expecting something, it takes you just under a second to react to it generally. This means if you're not expecting a breach flash, it's very unlikely you're going to dodge a breach flash. Try to anticipate flashes before they come, because this will give you the best chance of dodging them. If you're having trouble aiming during a match, try to practice on your teammates' heads during the buy phase. I see players like Scream do this a lot, and I've noticed it helps myself as well. If you're on low HP, it's a good idea to take headshot angles, because it will make your opponents have to work harder for the kill. When playing deathmatch, stop playing to win it and start playing to practice for the real game. Rather than searching for kills, try to clear angles how you would normally clear them. This is going to get you killed sometimes, but it's okay, you'll train your muscle memory better and it will transfer over to a real game more cleanly. A good smoke won't bleed out into the doorway towards where you're defending. The reason is, enemies can take advantage of this smoke to help isolate angles. Instead, place the smoke just a little bit deeper in the doorway, so if they step out, they can't isolate their angles as well. On a similar topic, if you're in a retake scenario, you should almost always smoke the bomb off rather than smoking the entrance. If you smoke the bomb, your teammates can hold enemies out while you're protected from all angles. If you smoke the entrance, your teammates can't hold the enemies out. It's a pretty common, underutilized strategy to destroy the door on A-side ascent on defense at the start of the round. This can make it more difficult for the offense to take the site, because they'll never get that security of shutting the door. Sometimes you can even catch players who come over to shut the door, not realizing that it's already been destroyed. If you're the only player defending a site, try to play a position where you can actually fall back if you get pushed. If you put yourself in a one and done, chances are you're going to get traded. If you don't know what to do on offense, start by asking your teammate to help you grab an ult orb. This will give you a clear mini objective that will help your team grab territory while also getting you an ultimate advantage. This is a tip I've always thought, but I heard it from Boaster the other day, so it validated me. Picking agents you aren't comfortable on just to fill a proper team comp probably isn't the best idea. The only role that is 100% necessary to have on a team really is controller, but as long as your team has smokes, you can get away without a sentinel, initiator, or even a duelist if it comes to it. It's not optimal, but it's also not optimal for you to play agents you don't really know how to play. Keep that in mind. Try not to address players directly when looking for solutions. Remember, it's a team game and no one player is responsible for a loss. You'll have a higher chance of winning if, rather than singling out one player, refer to the team as a whole and talk about how you can improve. If one player is having a bad game, that happens, but how can the other players play around them better to still come out with a win? The operator is a tool and should be used as such. If the enemy team is dry peeking a lot of angles, maybe it's time to pick up an operator and punish them. If you're the only duelist on your team and you're playing Reyna, maybe it's not the time to use that tool. Your team probably needs you on the front line. Try to combo your utility with other players. If you notice your Sova is throwing a recon onto Sight for a retake, that's a good time for your Omen Blind, and a good time for your Raze Grenade, and a good time for your Brimstone Ult. The enemy can only deal with so much util at once. There's tons of lines on the walls at head level to help you with your crosshair placement. Try to keep an eye out for these and use them. If you're getting pushed, try not to hide deep in the corner. If you're right against the wall, there's only one direction you can strafe to get out, and it makes you really easy to kill. Also, angle advantage is a thing, so that can be problematic as well. Speaking of angle advantage, if you're closer to the corner of a wall than an enemy, they will see you before you see them. This is called angle advantage. If your teammate already pushed through a smoke and didn't die, it's probably safe for you to push through that smoke to help them. If you're staying in a smoke, you're baiting, and I promise you can help them more when you can actually see the enemies. If you start defusing the spike before the outer ring appears, you're good. If you don't, you're probably fried. Oh, also the spike turns red when being defused. The spike actually gets placed in whatever direction you're facing, so if you're facing into the corner of a wall, it will give the defenders less room to defuse from. You can also use this to place the spike on top of B site on bind. If you think a player is aiming at your location, you can jiggle peek them to pull their crosshair closer to the corner, and then immediately after wide swing them to throw off their aim. This is an example of this on screen. If you know an enemy is low, don't aim for their head. Instead, lower your crosshair placement to chest level to give you the best chance of killing them. With shotguns, you should aim the center of your crosshair at their neck, because the pellets spread in a way that fills the whole circle, so this is how you'll get the most damage out of it. I once heard Ten say the best way to climb a Valorant isn't by playing more, it's by maximizing the efficiency of your games when you play. What he meant by this was it's actually a lot better to focus on having a clear mental and performing well in 1-3 games than it is to try to grind it out to climb. If you're going to have a long play session and are looking to still climb as best as possible, maybe consider having an alt account or playing unrated after a few comp games. Don't re-peek the same angle twice, generally speaking. Players will be expecting you to re-peek and it will normally result in you getting killed. Unless you're a jet main, then just do what you want. Unrated is a great way to practice playing aggressive without worrying about losing your team the game. Unrated sounded pretty lame to me for a while, but honestly, I have more fun playing unrated than comp lately. Grab some friends and just go run around like idiots, you'll actually build confidence surprisingly fast. Valorant doesn't have replays yet, but you can actually record your games using any clipping software and then review them to improve. I use an app called Outplayed. This clips all my kills, deaths, and assists, and then I can go through and analyze what I did wrong throughout the game. This is a great way to notice bad habits and improve. If you're fighting somebody who is using a Sheriff, do not stand still. And no, I don't mean run and gun, but make sure to counter strafe between bursts and absolutely do not crouch. Remember, the Sheriff is a headshot weapon, and if you crouch, you're making the shot really easy for them. Similarly, if somebody has a Marshall, don't fight them on a headshot angle if you can avoid it. You're basically just asking to get eco'd. When players grab ultimate orbs, it actually appears on the scoreboard. You can figure out where some players are based off of this, because if you see somebody's portrait light up and you're near the B orb, you know that they must have grabbed the A orb. Even something as subtle as standing on a slightly elevated surface can give you an advantage in a gunfight. Try to always be thinking about how you can throw off the enemy's pre-aim to help you win more fights. On bind, if you throw something through the teleporter to open the doors before you TP, you can normally catch players more off guard than if you just take the TP. It doesn't really register in players' brains the same way abilities go through the teleporter as when players go through, so by opening up the doors, you can make it so you can capitalize faster. If you're having trouble dealing with hard pushes, try buying a judge. Don't let your ego hold you back, the judge is a really good answer for dealing with stupid aggression. Generally, the easiest way to win a game is by picking out the weakest link on the enemy team and placing pressure on them. It sounds kinda mean, but they're having a rough game, and that's to your advantage. If your team has a numbers advantage, try not to get over aggressive. Remember, you're ahead, you don't need to be risking things. Ultimates are meant to be used. Don't be the person who used their Raze ult one round and a half. When you have that stuff available, use it. It's better to get some value out of it than no value. If you see your teammate is sitting in a corner looking for a play, try to make noise to grab the enemy's attention. You don't even need to be shooting at anything, but just by making noise, you can set that player up to get two kills, sometimes even more. When standing behind a smoke, don't stand in spots where people would pre-fire. This one feels pretty obvious, but I can't tell you how many times on offense people stand in common spots behind smokes and get killed. There's no skybox in this game, meaning you are intended to learn lineups. If this was the sign that you needed, stop being lazy, and if you're playing an agent that can have lineups, then you should go spend 20 minutes in a custom game and learn a few. You'll be glad that you did. And lastly, if you're looking for the best way to improve at Valorant by far, you can find Smurf commentaries, lineups, and more all available on skillcap.com. This is by far the fastest way to improve at Valorant, and it's also backed by our rank improvement guarantee, so if you don't get value out of it, there is literally no risk. Come join over 500,000 satisfied members, improve that KDA, and get the rank that you've always wanted at skillcap.com. Link in the description below. Anyway, though, that is all 50 tips. I'm not entirely entirely sure if I made it in under 10 minutes, but the editor can let you know. I might have done a terrible job on the time, but I hope at the very least you guys learned something new today. As always, if you guys enjoyed the video, be sure to drop a like and subscribe to the channel down below. It really does help us out. And as always, my name's King, and we here at SkillCapped want to thank you all for watching. We'll catch you in the next one.